गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम भद्रं कर्णे विश्रुणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागंसस्तनूभिः जशेम देवहितं जदायुः। स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं लोकशंकरं। Today we shall see only introduction to Mandukya Upanishad. From the basics again we'll begin, because knowledge has to be re-emphasized again and again repeatedly, so he has to make it our own. Now, you know, just to, we have Upanishads, Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda and Atharvana Veda. And this Upanishad comes from Atharva Veda. And each of these Vedas are divided into three portions. One is, as you know, first earliest part of each of the Upanishad is Mantra Bhaga. Mantra Bhaga contains various hymns praising the God, the expression of the God. And full of poetry. In every Upanishad, every Veda, the earliest part, Mantra Bhaga, this is the Mantra Bhaga. And then in Brahmana Bhaga, is the second Bhaga, middle portion of each Veda, wherein rituals are elaborately given to propitiate these various gods, to seek their blessings, to remain peaceful, contented, happy, healthy, so these Brahmana Bhaga contains rituals. Mantra Bhaga, various praises and hymns. Aranyaka, Aranyaka means forest. In this Aranyaka Bhaga, this Upanishad Bhaga contains philosophical discussions held by the great rishis with their disciples and devotees, remaining in deep jungles or forests, away from this regular life. Now, having understood this much, we saw Mandukya Upanishad is from Atharvana Veda, and this is, in terms of number of verses, this is the shortest Upanishad. It contains only 12 verses. Upanishad contains only 12. And because of its brevity, this becomes very difficult to understand by an ordinary seeker. And therefore, grand guru, guru's guru of Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya, that is Sri Gaudapada Acharya, wrote Karika on this. Gaudapada is said that he is from Gauda Desha or Bengal, West Bengal. Gaudapada himself was a great yogi, Mahayogi, and a great Advaiti. We will see now, slowly. Therefore, nobody considers the study of Mandukya Upanishad without Karika as complete. So with Karika, one has to study Mandukya Upanishad. Now there are so much, some Western authors say that even the mantra portion of Mandukya Upanishad, actually it is not Upanishad, it is Karika only, it is written by Gaudapada only, some Western authors say. But some other, or Madhvacharyaji and all, they say that even Karika is Upanishad mantras only. But there is no need for us to enter into all these arguments. Bhagavan Shankaracharya and earlier Acharyas also quoted this Upanishad, Mandukya Upanishad, so we don't have to have any doubts. It is Upanishad, there is Upanishad called Mandukya Upanishad with 12 mantras, and Karika written by Gaudapada, grand guru of Sri Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. Now, what is Karika? Karika means, is not a commentary. It is like a gloss. One more thing, these karikas are written in the form of shlokas, verses. And the very purpose of gloss or karika is to expound only an aspect of a particular doctrine. I am only concising the introduction given by Gurudev and also other Mahatmas. So Karika is not a commentary. Commentary is exhaustive. But Karika provides a gloss to expound a particular aspect of this doctrine, so that these verses can be easily memorized by the student. These principles or the Karika or the gloss as principles can be easily memorized by the student. This is the purpose. So these are verses. Otherwise, we find sutras, any sutra you take, or mantras, we find all these things in prose, not a form. Most of the mantras we find prose form. Sutras, purpose of sutra is to expound the whole aspect of or all aspects involved in particular doctrine. Asandigdham, all those things are there. Now, in Mandukya Upanishad, now let us see one aspect of it, then we come to different aspects of Mandukya Upanishad. You all know Manduka means frog. So Gurudev says it becomes a froggish scripture. Inverted commas. Now Gurudev mentioned in his commentary that he came across a Mahatma. He gave very interesting explanation about this Mandukya. So that he shared. And we will also see other aspects of other introduction also about Mandukya Upanishad. Now, what is a frog? Frog is an animal which remains 9 to 10 months always hidden, unseen, under waters, in the mud at the bottom of dirt and rubbish. All those places it remains. That means only for about 2 to 3 months in peak rainy season you see frogs coming out and croaking. Otherwise, most of their time is spent hidden. Okay. They remain secluded, renouncing all activities. Therefore, Gurudev says that Mahatma told, and one more point is, in the rainy season, they come out to croak, to give their message, though harsh, not so pleasant to listen to the croaks of the sounds of the frog, you know. But suddenly lends a charm of its own to the wet and the weeping days, the rainy days. That means frogs convey not a melodious message, but they convey without any emotion added to it. And nearest to the frog, Gurudev says, is a true Mahatma. Why? Because most of the time, Mahatmas live in seclusion. Great sages and saints. Even though you may find their ashrams in cities now, but even then they are secluded. Most of the time they remain calm and quiet. And in olden days, when they are secluded, staying in Himalayan mountains, etc., far away, removed from public, and only during Chaturmasya you see them during rainy season. And almost all these great Mahatmas give up their seclusion and Chaturmasya Diksha, Masya Diksha, where they settle in one place, engage themselves in discourses, bhajan, satsang, giving their message to the people. Rainy season, because no work can be done, so there is no busy life also. So those 4 days, 4 months, or 3 to 4 months are enjoyed as holidays. So both the people also used to listen, spend time in gaining knowledge from the Mahatmas. Mahatmas also were seen giving their messages. They are seen even today, even such Mahatmas also, giving their messages to the public with love and affection. So, therefore, this frog, Manduka, is equal to, that sense, it is called Mandukya Upanishad. Now, another sense also is there that we will see later on. Now, as I mentioned, this is from Atharvana Veda, contains only 12 verses. There is a rishi called Mandukya Rishi. Another viewpoint. This Mandukya Rishi was the mantra drashta of this Upanishad called Mandukya Upanishad. Who is Mandukya? One who, maybe he was born in Manduka Gotra or Manduka Vamsha. Therefore, he is called as Mandukya. Born in the Vamsha of Manduka or Mantu Manduka. Therefore, he is called Mandukya. So, Vamsha or Gotra. There is a story also, ancient story attached to it. Though it is symbolic, but again, we have to understand. There were no rains some time back. Sometimes, one time when there were no rains, Vasishtha Rishi, because of his tapas, had seen, as he was the mantra drashta, seen mantras by invoking which one gets rain. So having seen those mantras, having realized them, he chanted. When the rain started happening, all the frogs came out singing along with Vasishtha Rishi. And Vasishtha felt so happy that they also joined me in their own way, like squirrel in Ramayana. So the story goes on, but Vasishtha Rishi blessed them. Like, I am a mantra drashta, you all also become mantra drashtas. Therefore, a kahani hai ki all those mandukas of those times, at that time under Vasishtha Rishi, they became. That means what? Now club it, they need not be frog in form. They could be Mahatmas who joined Vasishtha Rishi, came out of the Chaturmasya, as Gurudev mentioned. So they all also became Mantra Drashtas. So in that Vamsha, Mandukya Rishi was born, therefore Mandukya. And Mandukya Rishi became Drashta of this Upanishad, therefore he became Mandukya Upanishad. Okay. Now, one message of Mandukya Upanishad is that most of the time secluded comes out. Now, second thing is very interesting. Frog doesn't walk. Frog only jumps. To move from one place to other place, frog jumps. Similarly, the techniques are given in this Upanishad to a froggy type seeker who is capable of jumping, to jump and reach the Turiya state, not necessarily going through all the travel like ant. And interesting, therefore, this kind of jumping, through jumping, one state par karke dusra state par karke tisra state, so Vishva Taijasa Prajna, Virat Hiranyagarbha Mahatattva or Ishwaratva. So crossing by jumping, method is by jumping. Therefore, This kind of jumping and reaching is called manduka pluti nyaya. It is called manduka pluti nyaya, wherein seeker is taught how to quickly change his identification from one level to other level of consciousness, jumping. Unlike ants, they travel, they cross, they have to, every inch they have to travel, every centimeter, a millimeter they have to travel. Therefore, it is called manduka pluti nyaya. Yahan pe kya hai? There is no need to walk step by step. That is the meaning. One more thing. How does a frog move forward? Actually speaking, frog moves forward, but moving forward is always started with moving backward. If you see the frog, frog jumps. Before jumping, first it lifts its back portion up and move slightly backward. Slightly backward and then jumps. Jumps what? Not horizontal, not like this. It just goes to other dimension. Similarly, to attain Paramatma, where should we go? Is a question. Should we move forward or backward? The answer is backward. Why? If we move forward in front of our indriyas, in front of our jnanendriyas, what is there is not Paramatma but the samsara. Therefore, when we move forward, simply moving forward horizontally, we reach only new realms or new, we put new chains of samsara to ourselves. Therefore, Mahatmas have said, "Hamare aage keval sansar hi hai, therefore, we must learn how to move backward and jump." Not like ant, like moving forward every step and trying to reach destination. Paramatma is inside. Paramatma is in self-withdrawal from the void. I cannot, in search of Paramatma, walk into the world. Wherever I go, any pilgrimage that I undertake, it is all actually not for Paramatma. Paramatma is inside. Avrutta chakshuhu amrutattvam icchami. So therefore, how to come? So leave the drishya prapancham, what is seen, objective world, and come to netra, eyes. Because Vishwa, the waking Purusha, Jagrat Purusha, is seated in eye. And afterwards, go to, next jump is throat, Kanthasthanam, where the dreamer is seated. And the next jump is Hrudayasthanam, Prajna, where is deep sleeper, asleep state, the Prajna is seated, one who sleeps. From there, discover the Paramatma. So, what is happening? Come to Prajna, leave the Kanthasthana, first leave the Netra, go to Kantha, and leave the Kantha, and come to Hrudayasthanam, and leave the heart also, and establish yourself in your own fullness. Because in heart only the truth is to be discovered. Hrudaya kohara madhye kevalam brahma matram. Taittirabhijat also we saw. Yo veda nihitam guhayam Parame Vyoman. therefore this jumping is given, jumping technique, by adjusting our outlooks. Therefore throat is swapna and heart is sushupti, so this is the method of jumping. Ab dekhiye, suppose main aapko udaharan mein de raha hu, all the four legs or whatever hands are called are legs of frog, suppose are grounded with the help of a fevicol to the ground, can it jump? You can only try to lift, you cannot even lift. A movement of muscles are seen in the frog, but actually it cannot lift and it cannot jump forward or jump. Similarly, we are so deeply rooted, attached to OET, we think we are not attached, but we are. So we are only intellectual, we entertain thoughts to embrace the reality without breaking the shackles or without unchaining ourselves from the OET. And unchaining from the OET will not take place simply by thought, by rejection, by saying no to it, but only by fulfilling our karma and duties. Remember, a seeker prarabdha is not only individual prarabdha. Others' prarabdha also works on you. This we miss the point. Somebody says, no, I don't want to take birth, but many others want you to take birth. Now what will you do? I don't want to live in this house now. I want to go away. But many people want you to live in the house. What will you do? Think. I run away from home and they constantly invoke, curse you, and therefore next life, double life, you are attached to house. One for the missing, other is for the postponing, the extra punishment. So anxiety in all of us is that suddenly overnight we become a frog, we reach that Paramatma. I can develop distaste towards the world. I hate this world. I hate naukri. I hate earning. I hate my father and mother. I hate looking after them. Responsibilities I don't want. I don't want to take any responsibilities. I am not interested in anything. I just wanted to win. That also will come now, that thought also will come now. So don't think that we are free like frog to jump. We may be having the capacity to jump. We may be calling ourselves as frogs, yet our legs are tied to the ground, so we cannot jump. Humorously, lighter way, sometimes I also feel that nobody should attend the morning class so that I can rest. So I keep कभी कभी यहाँ आके आके देखता हूँ कोई आया क्या. सब लोग आ गए बोलते हैं. सब लोग आ गए. Why? So because your prarabdha to listen is binding me to talk. Some days where I don't want to talk, also I am forced to talk. This is called, I can't jump. Same people who think that classes are very good, etc., etc., if I stop taking classes, I become object of hatred to all of them. It is true. So one day you praise, second day you criticize, third day you hate, fourth day you murder mentally, and fifth day, this is how the human mind works towards different vastus, different objects. That's how we are caught up in this world. We don't understand that samasti prarabdha or others prarabdha is working on me. Sometimes my individual prarabdha is less, but parechha prarabdha, anicha prarabdha is more. Therefore, here in this Mandukya Upanishad or Manduka Pluti Nyaya, there is no pravritti to move forward. There is only pravritti to, there is only nivritti. It is only to become nivritti. Therefore, it is called as Mandukya Nyaya. What is Mandukya Nyaya? Nivritti. Nivritti means what? You cannot do nivritti unless you unchain yourself, untie yourself with the OET. Please understand this. Intellectually we may be interested, but physically or practically we cannot go ahead. So therefore, now having understood this, but this process also, nivritti or this manduka, is also involves in a long process. Don't think this process takes long time. Once we are free to take off, taking off is only fraction of second. To prepare the flight to take off takes hell a lot of time. Actually, taking off the ground is a matter of, once it is on runway and you started moving, signals were given and no more bondage to the airport, you are free to fly. When signal is given, how many minutes will it take to fly? Within 1 minute you are in the space above the ground. Think. Therefore, Mahatma says, even closing and opening of eyes may involve some exertion. But in knowing Paramatma, even this much of exertion also is not there. It is my own Swarupa. I am already that. Only efforts are seen. If it is anya vastu, to attain that efforts are seen. Therefore, amara kya pavi, even though it is always available, we feel it is lost. Jo actually apna nahi hai, wo apna samajhte hai. Jo apna hi, pehle se hi, hum usko dur samajhte hai. Kya pareshani. Now, let us again switch over to some other points from Gurudev. Gurudev says, this Upanishad, I read certain quotations, quote, this Upanishad prepares the student to hear something of their intellectual and mental follies, and they are sufficiently warned that the very declarations have been the least sweetened by any sentimentality or emotion. Wonderful. इसका मतलब क्या है? This Upanishad prepares a student to expose or exposes us to our own intellectual and mental follies or foolish thinking. And in that process, no sentiment is attached to it. It is there, no, satyam vada, priyam vada, this principle is not there. Satyam vada, priyamaya, apriyam, that's it. No sentiment is attached to it. Nothing is dipped in sweet language. It is just declared the truth. Truth is declared. This is the truth. So, in student has to prepare himself or herself to listen to the naked truths. bitter truths. They are truth only. There is nothing untruth in this. But it is not palatable. We can't digest it. Because, you know, it takes us totally away from our understanding, our concepts, ideologies. Everything is smashed. Everything is crushed. All our thought structure is crushed. And we can't stand to it. One more thing. So Gurudev says, the Upanishad declares the uncut, raw truth without any decorations or polish, so that in its very roughness it shall wound our intellect and mind and make us revolt against the very concept and its implication. मैं वार्निंग दे रहा हूँ आपको. मांडी को सुनने के बाद फिर आपको आप बिगड़ गए समझो तो आई एम नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल. बिगड़ गए माने आप ही कारण है. वेरी डेंजरस. व्हाट ऑल वी हैव बीन होल्डिंग द थॉट्स देयर वन बाय वन स्मैश्ड. I take support, that is removed. I take one, take another support of that is also removed. I become supportless. And the master is no mercy, has no mercy. In Muktikopanishad also it says, मांडुक्यमेकं केवलं मुमुक्षूणां विमुक्तये. ओनली एकं मांडुक्यम इज एनफ. वन मांडुक्य उपनिषद इज एनफ अमंग द सीकर्स फॉर देयर लिबरेशन. देयर इज नो अदर उपनिषद इज रिक्वायर्ड. नाउ फर्दर इन दिस उपनिषद, बिकॉज अवर लाइफ, philosophy of life, whether in east or west, generally we think our study is complete only by studying, we claim exhaustively, or the waking plane. Dream state, deep sleep state are never brought into our education. We feel study of life means study of waking plane. And that is a partial view. Incomplete. Therefore, as great Mahatmas say, study means study of life, study of this means what? We must study all the three states of consciousness, its interplay or interrelations, how they work in the individual. So only when I study all the three planes of consciousness, waking, dream and deep sleep state, my study of life would become complete. That's why question is asked in Mandukya Upanishad also. Why can't the dream world be real and the waking plane is only you are visiting? Now we think waking is real and that dream is dream. But why can't the dream level be continuous? That could be reality, relative reality, and this could be a temporary plane where I occasionally enter and go back to my original state called dream. Why should we be conditioned that this is waking and that is dream and temporary? On what grounds we take this for granted? So we take it for granted that waking plane is real, though we say unreal, unreal, कहने के लिए. But we take very seriously our health, our life, our living, our concepts. Very seriously we take in Mandukya Upanishad. First of all, where is the world? Ajatavada. Never there was any world born. But Lord created, who is the Lord? He never created anything. But this creation, what we are talking about, that is in your mind. Nothing has happened, nothing has happened. No projection, no projection. Ajatavada. So, mere samne itna dikhai de rahe hai, that is all your foolishness. I can't believe it, you are not prepared for it. We are not prepared for it. We are prepared, go to Mandir, get up early morning, sun, day, night, Uttarayana, Punyakala, Dakshinayana, Punyakala, Jeeva, Marana, Janma, Srushti, Dharma, Adharma. These are very happy for us. When I transcend in my meditation, or even if I get that click of understanding, even slightly, maybe intellectually, we can come to realize that waking plane cannot be the reality. We know, but we are scared of our death. We know, yet we give importance to the outer world. So this is not an ordinary vyavahar ke liye jo seeker nahi hai. This is a seeker meant for only realization. So to that seeker only Mandukya addresses. Again, remember, we can understand this, appreciate only when we are not caught up with our own fancies. First clean the system. Then only the truth can be revealed. So therefore, philosophy should be an interpretation of the totality of human experience or of the whole of life from the standpoint of truth. Both Shankara and Gaudapada gave their assent to this definition. So a complete study of all the three states of consciousness from the standpoint of Turiyat is all illusion. Then the life study is complete. Then I know, even because I am not awakened, but I know that because on the strength of the scriptures and Guru's Vakya Upadesha, that this is all Mithya. I understood what is the meaning of Mithya also, that it can't be put under the column of Asti, Sat or Asat, but apparently seen, but happening for transactional purposes, relatively truth. But unless I study all the three states together, I can't understand what life is. Therefore, Mandukya explains all the three planes of consciousness one by one. अपना घर को समझो. घर को समझना माने रूम जार दे. घर को संभालना या समझना माने इवन ए स्थूल हाउस, ग्रॉस हाउस, यू वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड, यू मस्ट नो द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द हाउस, यू मस्ट कीप ऑल रूम्स क्लीन एंड नीट. You must know the switches availability, water pipes, everything. You must know the house. You can't take only drawing room for granted and make other, keep other rooms as kachara, ignore it. I don't know what is bedroom, and what is kitchen, but I keep front room very clean and neat. Or another aspect we take, simple for understanding. We have to take care of in life while living. We have to take care of all aspects of our life. We should take care of people also. We should take care of wealth also. We should take care of our dharma also. We should take care of our responsibilities also. No. I only take care of one aspect of my life at the cost of others. Then it is not total living. I must take care of health also. Relationships also. Money also. Prosperity also. So I cannot say I only take one aspect of life and stick to it. Sare baki sab bhaad mein jaane do. That is how people live. Either money is only important value at the cost of health, relations, members, dharma. No. All these are renounced. Only money. Or I am so lazy, I only quote some Upanishads for my convenience sake and become more lazy. Irresponsible I am. Such people are there. Such youngsters are there. Such elders are there. Only philosophy means something philosophy. Attempting everywhere in every organization. Get confused. Pagal duniya aisa. Therefore, I must take all aspects of it. And I cannot take care of only health, exercise, but robust body I built, but doing nothing for myself or for the country. What is the use of that robust body? You get my point? Similarly, only one aspect of one waking plane consciousness, only that is one state of consciousness alone, I take it as reality. Rest all, I don't know. I ignore, I don't study. My other two rooms, in three rooms I am caught up. Three pura rahasya. That's incomplete. Therefore Gurudev says, the spirit of research and scholarship brought into the study of life by these great rishis is unique in man's history of thought. There is no attachment or sentimentality and no emotion. This was a quest for truth, and truly they sought nothing but truth. However unpleasant might have been the conclusions which they had to arrive during their inquiries, they did not get anxious or worried or discouraged or frightened by them. They are the rishis. So, I think we will stop here, and some more data is there, certain thoughts, and then we will have to study after some more thoughts Mangala Acharana by Acharya Shankar. That also takes lot of time to understand. Beautiful it is. And then we have to study Sambandha Bhashya. And then we have to enter into Agama Prakarana. In Agama Prakarana, we find 12 mantras of the Upanishad, and in between, Karika Slokas are thrown, glossary, to make gloss, to explain the mantras. So it takes long time to study this Mandukya Upanishad. Are you prepared? So don't hurry me. आज कुछ सुनाया नहीं मांडव्य उपनिषद. सो बी पेशेंट. सो स्लोली वी गो. नो हरी. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम सतपुरुनाथ महाराज की जय।